Health is like your playlist. You never know what's coming next, whether you need a checkup, new medicine, or something more urgent. You need to know where to go. Enter Emory. With access to over 120 primary care locations and nearly 60-minute clinics and urgent care centers across the region, where you're in the hands of specially trained doctors and nurses, so you're covered no matter what. Click on this banner to find a location near you.
Blog Talk Radio.
Malcolm Garvey Huey, study Malcolm Garvey Huey. Their life was like a movie, study Malcolm Garvey Huey. Malcolm Garvey Huey, Malcolm Garvey Huey. Their life was like a movie. I die, I organize. Everything I do's revolutionize. I build what's good for the whole damn hood. Study G's like these really think you should. I study Malcolm Garvey Huey, Malcolm Garvey Huey. Marcel Cody with the Uzi, listening to Fela Kuti. I'm a goon with the machete. Stress me if it's jelly, got the Santos for the Hexy to protect me, so respect me, this is heavy, legendary, revolutionary, my wifey, she resurrect me when they thought they had me buried, took me out the cemetery, now it's family over every, cause it's all that's necessary to avoid the commissary, I'ma live for you five, so I stop to get high, if you know then you recognize, it's that black and brown pride, it's the power of the mind, RBG, God divine, you can see through the lies, if you can read between the lines, I live, I die, I organize everything I do, revolutionize. I build what's good for the whole damn hood. Study G's like these really get you sure. Malcolm Garvey Huey, study Malcolm Garvey Huey, Malcolm Garvey Huey,
Malcolm Garvey Huey, Bungie Bobby, Pac and Tukey. Sitting by the door so you can say I'm acting spooky. Just like in the movie, son, you better pack your tule. Niggas switch, be acting fruity, you'll be cracking like they pookie. Rather smoke a doobie then be burning and eluding. Bang, bang, pig shooting. We should blame Rudy Julie. Yanny for the camera, shine a white and nose candy. Let you banging on the system. You a gangster wearing panties. RBG, my family from the Bronx to Miami. Police cannot stand me. Pacquiao like a Manny. Call me little Bobby Hutton, cause I'm first to push the button. Rappers don't be saying nothing to the system. We say fuck 'em. This is for Nahanda, Mama C, Mama Akua. All the real OGs, I'm a soldier, cause you told me study Malcolm Garvey. Malcolm Garvey Huey, Malcolm Garvey Huey, young reporting in the duty.
Sticky icky, yours truly here for duty. Don DeVino, M.A. Uno, you know how we drop the jury. This is real, not a movie, not Mickey Donald Goofy. I'm a soldier, I avoid a bitch nigga like the cootie.
School face in a hoodie.
Fresh pair of khakis, we could do this like we fam. I go to war like the Apache, for whatever, I stay ready. I learned that in Tallahassee. Robert Toon, they used to school me as a juvie. Skipping classes, never let the system use me. My duty is my passes. Watch the homies in your army, they don't always show their badges. Keep your family living healthy, teach your children about their blackness. Teach your wifey how to use the ratchet. This shit is classic. Get your food, clothes, and shelter. Fuck your system, pimp it backwards. I ain't hating, I'm just saying. If you wanna be a rapper, study
Malcolm Garvey Huey. Malcolm Garvey Huey, study Malcolm Garvey Huey. Malcolm Garvey Huey, study Malcolm Garvey Huey. Malcolm Garvey Huey, study Malcolm Garvey Huey. Malcolm Garvey Huey.
A tactical approach is designed to get certain results.
Jet, shine your light, so a child may follow. Many have been lost along the way, yeah. Until tonight turns into tomorrow. Teach them to be careful while at play, yeah. There's nothing wrong with having fun. Don't let the system tame you. It's just a part of being young. And even though they're quick to blame you, picking on you like a plum, because your dream became true, now look what they've become. In open sight and plain view, they've already had a run. So meanwhile they try to change you. It's not over till it's done. So please remain the same you. Hey young world.
Hey young world.
Hey young world.
Hey young world.
Young world, the world is yours.
Hey young world,
hey young world,
hey young world,
hey young world,
the world is yours.
yet shine your light. So a child may follow. Many have been lost along the way.
Yeah.
Until tonight turns into tomorrow. Teach them to be careful while at play.
Yeah.
You might not think you know enough. Don't let that deter you. It's all a part of growing up. And we're all young enough to learn to. And don't you live life in a rush. The past cannot be returned to. And when you feel like giving up, remember patience is a virtue. When you fall, try to get up. Have some guts, I'm trying to urge you. Be proud of owning up. The truth will never hurt you. Hey, young world.
Hey, young world.
Hey, young world.
Hey, young world.
The world is yours.
Hey, young world.
Hey, young world.
Hey, young world.
The world is yours. Child may follow, cause many have been lost along the way.
Yeah.
Until tonight turns into tomorrow. Teach them to be careful while at play.
Yeah.
So when your rising starts, be wise and smart. Try and make your mark. Don't you hype and floss and drive too fast. Life too short. Try make good times last, cause time fly past. And if time is money, that means time cost. But it don't cost money to joke and laugh. So if you love somebody, hurry up and talk. Hey, young world.
Hey, young world.
Hey, young world.
World is yours.
Keep it real. out for you and for me. Yeah, I mean, we gotta buy black, be black, and everything else to take care of stuff.
Yeah, I mean,
in the words of the Honorable Marcus Mosiah Garvey, yeah, I mean.
I'm black and gangsta, I'm black and gangsta, I'm black and gangsta, I'm black and gangsta.
Made for me. Shout out to everyone that stayed with me, 'cause they know what's made for we.
and they know what we made to be.
So you gotta crown me. To my idols and my rivals, when you look at me now, though. Then you gotta crown me. To my idols and my rivals, when you look at me now, though. See every crown king.
In the name of Allah, the most merciful, the beneficent, the duo you worship, down aid, we see. So it's this great way, the way of those who have bestowed thy grace, the way of those whose portion is not of wrath and have known not astray.
Amen. Peace and love, blessed Lord, to the royal family, Ponsor, to the Bada Magun, and to the family Hotel. It's your host with the most, Lord, infinite, checking in live with our family. And today we got a powerful show, a powerful daily dose of bread going on. And on this Sunday, family, we will be joined by our beloved brother, the chairman, Fred Hampton Jr. Tonight, family, we're going to be getting into COINTELPRO. We're speaking about the COINTELPRO program that kind of affected, messed up a lot of the black movement. Pretty much COINTELPRO started by, initiated by J. Edgar Hoover through the FBI program, like part of different, I think I seen there were multiple points. One of the main points they kind of raised on my mind was like the fear to stop the fear of a black messiah. So it was going on around that time. We speaking about a lot of rising in our black community as far as our people rising up against the power struggle for protesting our freedom, protesting our claim and need to be free. So that's what we're going to be getting into tonight, family. As we wait on the arrival of our beloved brother, Chairman Fred Hampton Jr. We're definitely going to get into another musical break. We'll be right back with y'all, family.
This is the horror of my life, the beginning. It was me and Kuzo, that could be. Homie, you know, ever still me. And solo, then my pen got the best of me. Crusoe still had the wordplay. Coming cold, still finding me. Nemo, young, wild, and gifted. I know the lid, and I met Ruler J. Confidential clear, was created in the matrix. We got the time, man, wasn't the same thing. So I hope by when I did different direction. Started confidential entertainment, and it was a blessing. And the lesson to see the young the game. So I seen what the bird that we gave the game. See the cow on the beat, and I became an activist in these streets. Moved to the A, and I made E minor. We was wild with the music, A to the minor. Confidential change with J Maul, and I did a lie. Overall, under all, I'm trying to live my head cut dead like Reed. Now I'm in J, you crying king. The man with the plan, I'm B King. On that note, I'ma let my freedom reign.
I reflect on the life of mine. I won't change with a
dollar signs. Still, I had a brotherhood mind. This ain't natural. Like it goes factual. I can make it die. 22 is where I have been. So say hello to the bad guy. Who felt that?
Sure wasn't me.
I wasn't up with goals.
I'm trying to be seen in one day.
It all came full circle.
Meditating with Bob.
Tripping all purple.
Tupac,
Christ in my paws.
The greatest story ever told.
Living untold.
Brought me to Zion.
Let my hell off.
Down to my back like a lion.
The rules of the game.
On my pressure points.
Spound like the ashes on the end of blood.
Welcome to the end. Of a long episode of
supremacy.
Get it like a
xenophobe.
History
in the making.
When you hear my mind,
hard to see that I'm from this dirty side.
Yeah.
Blessed love, peace, and blood to the royal family. Y'all back on the Lord's Business Radio Show with the host with the most, Ross and Lord Infinite. And basically, as we wait on our guests to arrive in our studio with us tonight, family, I give y'all a briefing on with this program here that we are striving to build and ignite in the city of Atlanta, visionary leaders of society. And basically, the Lord's Business Radio Show is underneath that umbrella of visionary leaders. And the mission of visionary leaders is this. We have to strive to be the best for ourselves, our family, our community, and our nation. And in doing so, they come with like a 12-step program, if you will. Like steps one through three deal with self, and we get into a knowledge of self, application of knowledge, and self-sufficiency. And step four through six is our family, which get into knowledge of our roots, understanding our role in our family, learning to take care of our family, and community. Step seven through nine. Knowledge of our community, solving problems within our community, and giving back to our community. And step 10 through 12, which is our nation, knowledge of our nation, rebuilding and the building of our nation, and uplifting of our nation. And really, why this program so important? Because, like, when we breaking down the process, like we can't help nobody until we help ourselves. So that's why we start with self first. And a lot of time when we get into self understanding and self talk, we get into the phrase of the common idea of learning more about self, which equates to having knowledge of self. So definitely, family, like, once we have the knowledge of ourselves, then we can move accordingly and see how do we fit in our family, see our placement in our family, get a understanding of how the family unit works. I mean, the family is like a microcosm of our community. In our community, i.e., we subconsciously, we in reality become family. So within our family, we got to see the roles, understanding like how that team come about. And then we able to venture out into our community, like see how can we better our community, like for our people, family. So first we starting with developments and understanding and knowledge about ourselves. Then we get into the developments and knowledge and understanding about our family. Then we get into developments and knowledge and understanding about our community. Then we get into development, knowledge, and understanding about our nation. And a lot of time, we speak on nation building. But when we break down the definition and understanding and blueprint of what it means to be a nation. A nation is self-sufficient. A nation has its own army. A nation has its own food resource. A nation takes care of its people. So when we're speaking about nation building, we made an effort or an impact to suffice that accommodation of our food resources, our enforcing resources, our knowledge, like all the what we striving to do, like what we standing on as a nation. Then in reality, we can't really say we're a nation. That makes sense, right? So I challenge that question to a lot of people for, you know what I'm saying, they strive to be nation building. Like, we definitely it's imperative that we meditate on and contemplate on that. Like, when we speak about nation building, we gotta, Elder kind of broke it down to mean like this. Like, you know, it's basically like law. I'm like, what you mean? Like, law, like, it brought the way, broke law down, like, land, air, and water. So, when we speak about land, that dictates our territory. And air, like, our freedom to breathe. And freedom to breathe, and in actuality, the law, you know what I'm saying, is what governs a nation. So, man, we can't, but this topic get deep, but I ain't going to derail the conversation already pre-ordained on topic for tonight, as far as like what we're going to begin into when our beloved brother join us about his situation, and we'll speak freely and also to the listener audience anytime y'all want to chime in. And that's all, brother. Question, definitely do so. We'll receive you. We'll open arms to the conversation. But as far as like what I was just speaking about, I just want to give y'all a detailed overview on the program of visionary leaders of society. And like I said, right now we are building and launching that program here in the state of GA, Atlanta, Georgia, to be exact and correct. So we like ones and ones to keep in mind, ones and ones to be more open, so you probably can add their program to your state. So without further ado, I think we do have our beloved brother with us, fam. Peace and love, my brother.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you. You kind of going in and out a little bit, fam.
Okay, forgive me. I was trying to wait till I get to my destination, but I didn't know how much time we had. I'm really on the road back to the to the house. I got our time zones mixed up. You know, I thought I came an hour later. You know, so I wanted to try to call in before I lose you. So forgive me. I'm on the cell phone and I'm on the road at the same time.
All right, man. As long as you still able to get to your beef and your A where you going there, bro. Right now, I mean, the show, we only on stride to be on the air for about an hour. So you still got like
okay,
a good 45 minutes. So, I mean, you can kind of come on in and introduce yourself for the people, and then we'll kind of go from there. If that's all.
Okay, so you're right. So you're right. So you're right. I'm Chairman Fred Hampton Jr. I'm honored and humbled to be a servant of the people, as well as the international chairman. Well, I guess it's one of the same, but international chairman of the Black Panther Party Cubs. I'm also the son of Chairman Fred Hampton and also of Akua and Jerry Fonino's Deborah Johnson. I'm a former political prisoner. I can't say it enough. I'm honored and humbled to be a servant of the people in general. Let me say, I'm honored to be online with you, the listeners, and the people in general as well.
Yeah, most definitely. We're honored for you to be here, to take time even out of your schedule. You still multitask, my brother, and that's still an honor, and definitely a salute and big respect. Like, that being said, like, I mean, I know we done had a lot of privileged conversation. We never really brought it to the airway like that, but I was just reflecting and thinking about, like, that hardship. Like, I know you talk about it a lot of times in this friend, like, being a child, like, when you seen being a child with your mother, and you seen police when they came for your pops, you know what I'm saying, came for the OG, and, like, speaking about the COINTELPRO situation, like, from a psychological and a sprint, like, how did that affect you and how did that impact you to kind of still carry on that toy? So, I mean, because we see a lot of you and sons and children that don't fall in the same footsteps of their parents, but we see you out here on the front line. I mean, to be honest, I know the late chairman Fred on the scene, I know he'll be proud of you a bit, bro.
Well, I'm honored to walk in, not only attempt to walk in his footsteps, but in particular, his Paul steps, his path to Paul steps, you know. the deal is all of us, our people, African people, you know what I'm saying, particularly colonized people, all colonized people in general, we're damaged goods, and the deal is a lot of times we don't recognize who's the damager. I have been afforded the quote unquote luxury of having a graphic depiction of you know, so who is the damager? And the deal is that's the state, that's the system. Because the reality is this system, though it assassinated, though it took Chairman Fred as well as Defense Captain Mark Clark in a graphic way, it attempts to take all of our fathers whether it be shooting them down, locking them up, punking them out, stringing them up, or what have you. And that's how the old saying goes, knowing is half the battle. I can't, you know what I'm saying, I got a reality check before I got here. The first piece of steel I ever came into contact with was not a doctor's stethoscope. It was a Chicago Police Department's revolver being placed on my mother's to be pregnant, protruding 8.5 month pregnant belly. I was locked up before I got here. I was taken, you know, placed inside a jail. So that was my first jail cell. I was a political prisoner before I got here. So, not to sound macabre or, you know, so eerie, but the state helped my growth. It gave me a crash course in capitalism. You know what I'm saying? Before going to the cradle, I got a crash course in capitalism. I was hit to this system. You know how it gets down, how it deals with us, and a lot of us are misinformed. Whether it be the school system, the media, even our parents. You know, because a lot of times we're scared to talk about this here. But you know, I got the state told gave me a straight reality check before I got here, you know, and that we have a responsibility to resist and fight for our survival.
Yes, indeed, and a reality check, and that humbling, brother. I don't know if you got cut off or something, or you came to a stop, or you just come on trying to pull the idea together.
Yeah, no. I'm sticking and moving with you like in the boxing ring. Cause I watch you. I'm rapping this little neighborhood right now too. And I'm driving. You know, I got my trail car behind me. So we watch our surroundings too. You know what I'm saying? So I'm as you said earlier, multitasking. We call it the Black Panther Party Cubs. We call it doing the octopus tactic. You know, trying to do eight things at one time. You know, we gonna do it.
I already know how you move, man, and it's that powerful, man. You're honorable in the day and time, like, you know what I'm saying, like, you know what I'm saying, like, with the influence and And with your background, like a lot of people all over the nation know your power, Like one of the, they don't know him, might not know him personally, but they know of him anytime you speak of the Black Panther. Like you, three names you're going to hear, Bobby Seale, Fred Hampton, Sr., and Huey P. New. Like those three names, like they stamped in our brain for the, when you, anytime you think about the Black Panther.
Yeah. Yeah, and you know, I want to add this to it too, because in fact, one of my comrades he told me that's who he really was familiar with. But I want to stress this, that we have to also know about the Earl Anthony's, the agent of Vakatools, the William O'Neills, you know what I'm saying, the one who supplied the floor plan when Chairman Fred assassinated. We have to know about the state's attorney here with L.V. Hanahan. We have to know about the good, the bad, and the ugly, because like in a relationship, you know, if you just know the good things about your lady, or a lady don't know the good things about her guy, you know, so she really don't know the whole dynamics of it, you know. We have to, you know what I'm saying, the Black Panther Party, another instance is attempted to be romanticized, you know. But the deal is, a lot of heat come with this, you know, not try to run people away from it, but we gotta know this to really, even deep as our appreciation for the sacrifice, and, you know what I'm saying, for such forces who represent the Black Panther Party, you know. Chairman Frey was 21 years old, just turned 21 years old, and he was assassinated, you know. And it's a reason why the government don't want us to know the real deal. They try to ward them down. It's kind of like it was Malcolm X said that, when he talked about the March on Washington, he said the state says when they can't stop it, let's co-opt it, water it down, change it, make it something to be. There's been so many attempts to make bogus movies, unauthorized books, you know what I'm saying, you name it, to hijack his legacy. And we really got to fight to maintain that legacy, because, again, it's something that legacy of the Black Panther Party is something that sustains us through some serious situations. Again, legacy of the Black Panther Party is something that sustains us through some serious situations, you know. And some people in certain arenas, they can afford the luxury to have, you know, other schools of thoughts, and, you know, can come with some more, for lack of better terms, milquetoast, you know what I'm saying, type of discussions. The Black Panther Party turned the communities into classrooms, you know what I'm saying? We know it's not about happenstance. We say the Black Panther Party Cubs, that the media, and the different organizations, you know what I'm saying? They're trying to raise up different counterfeit, you know what I'm saying, representation of the Black Panther Party. You know what I'm saying? You say, you know, why don't they want to acknowledge, you know what I'm saying, oh, they just carry it on? Because they don't want the real deal to be known, because, again, it can become infectious, you know? Right now, as we speak, we fighting for the house that Chairman Fred grew up in. The house that, in fact, where the government had his phone, my grandmother, his mother's phone tapped when he's 14 years old. They had his phone tell. They thought it was a misprint. They said, this cat can't be no 14 years old. You know what I'm saying? This is after he took the junior NAACP from 7 to about 300 members in 7.5 month time period. They recognized his organized capability way back then. The Black Panther Party Cubs just came back from a Cub, we call it a Cub Caravan. We just got back from Louisiana, going out to see the Tombstone, grave site of Chairman Fred. A grave site in which, hey, more than flowers, what you see there more actually is the bullet riddled tombstone. The police threw this tombstone up every year, right now, to this day. They haven't forgotten, you know? And so when I come into town, they know we're there. They put a whole announcement out, you know, Chairman Fred and the Cubs are there. So we got to make that correlation, that concrete correlation to what's happening, what happened then to what's happening now.
Man, do you think, like the way I see it, I mean, I know we always got to keep on fighting, but it's like we done been knocked down from, like, how our brother Malcolm X, we done been knocked down, bamboozled, and led astray, like, on a very consistent time, like, in the midst of our, how to put it, our shortcomings and our far base, like, the enemy continue to progress and increase his stronghold on our people. So I ain't saying to stop fighting, but do you acknowledge like different roles or different methods in which we gotta fight? Cause I know right now, in the present day time, I know we physically equipped to beat them, like with they weaponry, like going out here and shooting down type of thing. We ain't equipped to fight them on their playing field.
Well, there's a lot of misconceptions about the Black Panther Party, you know, like even in regards to how they deal with the question of arms. In fact, it's a famous quote by Deputy Minister of Health, Ronald Doc Satchel. Ronald Doc Satchel, the Black Panther Party, said, yeah, we armed propaganda unit, you know what I'm saying? And a lot of people couldn't understand that. In fact, Minister UEP Newton, the party stressed the thing that they say that they must even politicize the gun. What makes their gun different than the state's gun? It's difficult. It's hard not to get caught up in defeatism. I mean, it's demoralizing. You know what I'm saying? I mean, I had to get on Facebook last night. You know what I'm saying? Just the case in Minnesota with the, you know what I'm saying, kids killing a brother back to back. You know what I'm saying? The case in Pittsburgh. You know what I'm saying? Killing brother Antoine Rose. You know, and then add to that, to add insult to injury, you see them bring up these old bogus counterfeit organizations. You know what I'm saying? Maybe they spokesperson. And then add to that is demoralizing how people a lot of times can't even deal with this scientifically. And that's a must. Chairman Fraser said revolution is a scientific art that must be perfected. You know, I was watching some cat, they going crazy about this cat Nas got the guy's name on the shirt. But actually he got somebody else's name. I mean, he got somebody else's t-shirt at the concert. But this is, and it's cool, but the deal is acknowledge for what it is. This is the time, you know, when he got a new release coming out, a new record coming. You know, this joke has been Silence of the Lambs before that, and it's cool, but accept it for what it is. You know what I'm saying? Like, don't make no fast food meal, no Sunday dinner. You know what I'm saying? Don't set yourself so disappointed. We have to deal with this stuff scientifically. We have to look at struggle scientifically. You know what I'm saying? We have to understand and grasp a politic that does not negate us to absolutes. Just because some cats do, you know, get online, so be it. I understand what the old mantra says. I believe it was Che Guevara, Malcolm X. No permanent friends, no permanent enemies, permanent interests. And our interests got to be our people. We must also understand that, as Minister UEP News said, the revolution is a protracted struggle. In other words, ain't no overnight thing. You know, and we got to correlate that to the saying that Chairman Long J. Dong said in the Red Book, if I move a grain of sand and my sons move a grain of sand and my sons move a grain of sand, you dig? We can move mountains. You know what I'm saying? So we didn't get put in this situation overnight. We're not going to get up out of it overnight. But we got to start really grasping the ability to look at this, you know what I'm saying, scientifically, and recognize also, you know what I'm saying, failure. As Marcus Garvey said, failure is not an option. And understand what Malcolm X said, even if you lay down and don't fight back, they still get on top of you and get out on you. So again, we have to do what Chairman Fred said also. Dare to struggle, dare to win. Don't dare to struggle, damn it, you don't deserve to win.
Yeah, yes indeed, man. Yes indeed. And I mean you said a mouthful, beloved brother. I just, when we say little sound bite, something that's sticking our mind, like it be the subtle thing. Like what you just said, like don't make a fast food meal or Sunday dinner. Man, like I ain't heard that yet, but that's so true though. Like when we looking at fast food, like something about a quick remedy, a quick placebo solution to the problem, but we gotta have that. Gotta have that Sunday dinner, like to sit down, like that true nourishment, not no fast food. Like, man, that's a powerful analogy, man. Like I can walk away with just hearing that right there. When we looking at the reality, that with a lot of time we like in this microwave generation, that what we do is like we try to resort or revert back to that fast food mentality. Yeah. Like, oh, this finna happen right now. This finna, like, a lot of us don't even want to put in that work no more. Like, your pa saying, you right now, like, what y'all doing? Y'all putting in that work. Like, knowing this ain't no happen overnight.
Man, you, can you still hear me? Can you hear me still?
Yeah, I can hear you, Bumbo.
Man, you, a lot of cats, they have no frame of reference. They have no frame of reference, no protracted struggle, you know? It's kind of like even, okay, let's go back with that analogy about the fast food meals. You know, man, you'd be hard-pressed to find somebody that cook home-cooked meals now. You know what I'm saying? This is a different Asian day, you know? So you're going to put something in common. A lot of people have no concept. Like, you know, like I tell you, in Chicago, which, you know, Chirac now,
You know, you can't say no. I told the cat they call the chief, they call Chief Keith. Now, I called him backstage at the Rock the Bells concert one time. I said, listen, Charlotte, check this out. I said, you make sure, you be very clear to make sure you spell your name C-H-E-E-L, not C-H-I-E-L. You know what I'm saying? These are not mobs, these are not organizations. You know what I'm saying? These are cliques. You know what I'm saying? And this ain't no slight on him. You know what I'm saying? This ain't nothing he did. It's a result of a destabilizing machine that's been put in place, because one of America's policies is to create chaos and then restore order. And that's whether you're talking about Iraq, Afghanistan, Africa, Cambodia, you know, or what have you. You know what I'm saying? But to come in acknowledging for what it is, you know what I'm saying? And you just can't say, well, out of desperation because you want it so bad, you want to call for something it is, you set yourself up with disappointment, you know what I'm saying?
I'm trying to connect the point you saying, like, that was something that Chief Key did, like, changing his name, like, with, like, making the name C-H-E-E-F and but C-I-E-F, or that was something that was put in his mind to do.
Say it again, brother, say it again.
No, I was trying to follow along the points you had made. You were like, Chief Key, instead of spelling his name, the chief, like C-I-C-H-I.
Okay, you know, it's the thing they say with this, with the C-H-E-E-F, that, you know, they say you chiefing, like you smoking a lot, you know? And I stated to him to make sure he spelled it that way, as opposed to C-H-I-E-F. Don't let no managers, don't let no record, don't let Jimmy Iovine, or no record companies, don't let no groupies come tell you nothing different. You know what I'm saying? So you see, you have to fight. You have to fight for the definition. You know what I'm saying? I don't care how I might happen to fix a car by happenstance. I'm not no mechanic. It was a joke they made about me when I was locked up. They say Chairman Fred can go to the Muslim service, stone meeting, disciple meeting, vice lord meeting, and still come out Chairman Fred. Everybody can't do that. You know what I'm saying? Because you a lot of these cats who don't have no concept of who they are. You know what I'm saying? The different organizations, like a lot of people raise criticism of the Black Panther Party. So I heard they work with these different the white people, so on and so forth. I said, but Chairman Fred made it very clear. You know, we're Vanguard Party. We pay the cost to be the boss. And that wasn't no subjective statement. And you know, it wasn't like this. These different white lefts had revised history and say the Rainbow Coalition was a bunch of groups of people just coming together, working because they liked each other. That wasn't the case. You know what I'm saying? Cause a lot of people, like you said earlier, a lot of people don't say they know about the Chairman Fred, but they actually don't. They don't. You know what I'm saying? Or the Black Panther Party. There's a lot of misconceptions about the Black Panther Party as well as Chairman Fred. In fact, I remember some cat, he ascribes to what we refer to as a culture nationalist line. You know what I'm saying? That's a line where you think this always going to take us getting, you know what I'm saying, donning some dashikis and recognizing that we black. And he was saying he disagreed with Chairman Fred's position about working with white people, so on and so forth. And when I asked him, I said, where do you get this information from? You know what I'm saying? What's your concept of Chairman Fred? And you know what I'm saying? This same cat, you know what I'm saying, who had the dashiki on talking this and that, he referenced the white. He said, this unauthorized book named this Assassin's Fred Helen by this white dude named Jeffrey Haas, who wrote a book, was unauthorized. I said, well, that's ironic that you would quote that book, you know what I'm saying, from a white dude. So the deal is a lot of people, or their first concept. Dave Chappelle said his first time hearing a Fred Hampton was through, I think, Noam Chomsky. You know what I'm saying?
Chairman.
I learned about Chairman Fred. I learned about Chairman Fred, you know what I'm saying, through the ghetto, same way with Malcolm X, he learned about American history, through his ghettos and through his prisons. You know what I'm saying? I learned about him through old guys running the garbage can, you know what I'm saying, burning wood. I learned about him, you know what I'm saying, through war stories about when he would go meet the Black Star Rangers. I learned about, you know what I'm saying, I learned the disciples, the former devil disciples, they would become the Black disciples, some of the different war stories. You know what I'm saying? I invested in the education of what it was. A lot of cats, you know what I'm saying, I learned about the contradictions, you know what I'm saying, we had to deal with different street organizations. I invested into it. I learned about it when I was in Menard, 1999, the same place as Chairman Fred in 1969, you know what I'm saying? So that's how I grasped it, you know what I'm saying, and I respect that legacy, and I protect it, you know what I'm saying? And but a lot of cats have got a watered down or a safer version, you know what I'm saying, or a Wakanda type of assessment of it, you know what I'm saying.
You gotta put that X cross with this.
Yeah, you know, you can dress up and say some good stuff, you know what I'm saying. You know, I mean, that's cool for rated PG, but we're doing some rated R realities, you know what I'm saying.
Yes, indeed, man. And I mean, like, even though I don't know the history, like, you know, you growing up at the park, but it's like you can see a lot of those ways. Like that, like my daddy just passed away last year myself. But I didn't, like, my daddy didn't really talk to me like that. But we used to talk, like we used to hang out, like, but he ain't really give me no conversation like do what I went through. I learned more about my daddy from being around the other friends and like being around people that, but I know your dad was such and such, he did. He used to be like that, man. He used to do X, Y, Z and stuff like that. And now I go to my dad and like, man, be true. He's like, yeah, son. But it went no, I ain't never get no conversation. Like, he ain't ready to come out and say, like, man, I went through that. It was just always in the midst of other energy. And I'm just, you going back. Like how you said, you learned about Chapman Press behind the scenes, like through the barbecues and the ghetto and stuff that kind of, about me and to my man, like that's how I learned a lot about my dad and learned how to respect him from where other people.
That's how. Because you know, your children, you know, all children, whether we want to admit it, all children are subjective. All children are subjective. In other words, a child sees their father as just their father a lot of times. Now they don't see him as though nobody's husband, nobody's son, grandson, so on and so forth. You know, they see their mother, someone's mother. I mean, it's their mother. You know what I'm saying? And through experiences, they're going to say, whoa, wait a minute. Mama got to do this. Daddy got to do this. You know what I'm saying? And also, familiarity breeds contempt. A lot of times, I got people in my family, you know what I'm saying? I got cousins who I just recently, you know what I'm saying? I was on the West Coast. He said, man, I didn't know you was a champion. You know what I'm saying? I couldn't have told him this here. You know what I'm saying? It take other people outside. When you close to people, it's like boxing, like fighting. You're too close up on it. You see it subjective. You don't see the overall scenario. You know what I'm saying? So I tell you, when you write up with your father, your mother, you don't see the different dynamics, how it impacts people's lives. So that's why... It's important that you said that too, because that's the deal. This goes to the importance of an objective analysis. Again, an objective analysis. See, we the Black Panther Party Cubs, we say subjectivity stunts one's ability to make proper summation. You never hear me say the police killed my daddy. Never. Never hear me say that. What you will hear me say is the government assassinated Chairman Fred. Now, that does not negate him being my father, because see, there's an old African saying to say, what's good for the family may not necessarily be good for the community. But what's good for the community is good for the family and the community. You know what I'm saying? But see, we have to stop putting this in context. You know what I'm saying? What dynamics make your father unique? What characteristics? You know what I'm saying? And the deal is you have to hear about these outside circumstances, extenuating, you know what I'm saying, circumstances. Because you did. We are deprived of that. Why you think they never show you? You can't find no black men, no images on TV and no movies, you know what I'm saying, a signs of strength. You know what I'm saying? Now, even the Good Times TV show, you never seen no images of James Evans outside the household. You know what I'm saying? You see it inside the household. We need examples of, you know what I'm saying, how did my father deal with this? How did he deal when he got into it such and such? You know what I'm saying? Even relationships, we are deprived of that. We're depressed. You know what I'm saying? They give us subjective little stuff. You know what I'm saying? They can, and we get caught with trivial things like, you know, this these U.S. presidential selections. Those ain't calling me elections. You know what I'm saying? You don't see white folks caught up with, excuse me, how Donald Trump, how he dressed, how he look, anything for policies. Excuse me. They feed us. Trivial stuff. Obama, this war coming. They feed us trivial, subjective. You know what I'm saying? We get caught up with how a person looks, as opposed to dealing with concrete policies. You know what I'm saying? In fact, it was a skit. Water. It was a skit on the Boondocks, and they were showing how they were asking Obama about some policies. President Obama some policies, and he kept referencing his daughter, like how his family, excuse me, so we need objective analysis, you know. Now, don't bear with me, excuse me, cut with me.
Yeah, that good, but you definitely right, and I remember that episode. Pulled out to you, like me, myself, and Michelle.
Yeah.
And both we're gonna be all right. But
yeah,
but I would just
that's all we get.
Yeah. Exactly. And I was there, banging though. I had lost my train of thought a little bit.
You barely hear Trump mention his sons in a subjective, personal way. You know what I'm saying?
They do
a policy, you know what I'm saying? But our people are giving these trivial, personal, subjective, who like who, you know what I'm saying? We get knocked up out here day to day, you know what I'm saying? I had to get on Facebook last night, you know what I mean? Man, they gunning us down one way or another, you know what I mean? Last 3-4 days, I mean, this is just what I know about. I mean, you know what I'm saying? We're talking about the Minnesota case, you know what I'm saying? And the brother named Thurman. I can't even keep up with these names no more. So it's so common. You know what I'm saying? The brother from Pittsburgh, Antoine Rose. This little brother who went to high school with me in Chicago. He called him Fats. Matter of fact, we're going to do a show on him this Wednesday, Free of My Radio. You know what I'm saying? They took this brother, they kidnapped, took him up the streets, took him out to 35th and Halsted Police Station. They say he pulled out a heart attack in Cook County Jail. They murdered him. Got a 16-year-old sister. On the south side of Chicago, 87 Dan Ryan. It's like she just jumped on, committed suicide, jumped on the railroad tracks. You know what I'm saying? This is something that's common that's going on in our community. We ain't got no time or no to play these type of personality games. You know what I'm saying? BET Awards, who wore this, who else on the red carpet? Imagine it's like somebody in Nazi Germany doing the gas chambers, talking about who got, you know what I'm saying, who dressed the best. You know?
Exactly. I was there going back into, I know I had found my train of thought though, cause the process you were thinking about, they give us, they take away our idea of that strong man, they take away our objective viewpoint of like what a man has to do. And I was just thinking, reflecting on in a lot of conversation I had, like with a lot of citizens still, like with my work on the community service side of things, like I always hear the question, like, where have our man at? Like, where are our men on the front line? And I see what I'm doing. I see what you guys are doing. But it's like, it's only a handful of us. And I just want to kind of throw that in there. Like, what's your take on that? Like, how can we?
I got somebody on the line. I'm going to tell them. Can I tell them to tune in real quick? How do I tell them to tune in real quick?
Go ahead. All right, cool.
Hold on.
But yeah, y'all hearing it here live tonight on the Lord's Business Radio Show with our beloved and honorable guest, Chairman Fred Hunter Jr., man. This is a powerful conversation right here. We getting into a family, and like the brother said, like, we can't dwell on a fast food solution. We can't let the fast food courses replace the full course, son and dinner. And they were talking
we back online with you. you were saying in regards to like the man. I'm real careful to pick my arguments. We struggle to win. We don't struggle for struggle's sake. You know what I'm saying? And a lot of times, I tell people, most of our debates is really not with the person that we're talking to. It's really what, if you listen to it closely, you debate, you know what I'm saying? One of the unique characteristics that imperialism has done with our people is they've got us so intertwined with the state. It's like, you know what I'm saying? Like when you go other places where it's an acknowledged war, you're able to say, okay, wait a minute, this is the U.S. interest. We have political prisoners. We have propaganda bombs. They have us so intertwined. It's difficult, like the Walking Dead or Body Snatchers. You know what I'm saying? Because you got people who don't want to see the person may look like their family members or their cousins or whatever. But you're really fighting a foreign entity, and people don't want to acknowledge it. At least in other wars, you have people that are dressed up and acknowledge. No, this is the German. This is the French army. You know what I'm saying? So we ought to. Because the psychic, as Frantz Fanon talked about, you know what I'm saying, black skin, white mask, you know, so it's so intertwined, and a lot of times we embody it. So a lot of times you even by clinical psychologists talk about how the pain and trauma is passed down generation to generation. Yeah, situation in South Korea, you might be locked up for time. You think you can get out of jail? No, they said, no, you got to stay. They're going to keep you there, keep your daughter or your son there, and your grandchild there. Because they had to weed out their particular thought process or their particular mindset. There's so much stuff that we're dealing with, so much trauma that's really – that's from yourself. I mean, you don't know who grandmother got raped or grandfather got raped. A lot of people are targeting their frustration against black men or black women. You know what I'm saying? And the deal is we're trying to heighten the contradictions to get to, it's like performing surgery, a scalpel. We're trying to get to the cancer without, you know what I'm saying, without cutting the colonized people. You know what I'm saying? It's a battle. It's a battle, you know what I'm saying? And we got some people that hold on so tight, you know what I'm saying? And we have to look at it objectively. Like, you look at the movies. And it's, you know what I'm saying? See, we look at our community, we look at different contradictions subjectively. We look at sex subjectively. You know what I'm saying? Well, this person fooled around this person, so on and so forth. Rome, U.S. imperialism. They look at, you know, they see it strategically. I mean, they talk about, like, they would go conquer countries, whether it be through fighting or taking them to bed, you know what I'm saying? You go look at it, how they view Cleopatra, you know what I'm saying? War tactics, you know what I'm saying? A lot of our people can't distinguish that. Even emasculation, it's a war tactic, you know what I'm saying? You're talking about a system that even views rape as war tactics. Now, that means, because a lot of us, we believe, we just see it as see it subjectively, but like even clinical psychologists say, no, it's a psychological dynamic to that, but we go further than that. Say no, it's more tense than that. It's political. You know what I'm saying? They would go through certain like on the plantation, even though the common plantation owner may know the different dynamics of it. You know what I'm saying? The whole strategy of, you know what I'm saying, raping in front of our women, our children, you know what I'm saying? It was strategic. It was a war tactic, you know? And we have to try to put this dynamic in the context. You know what I'm saying? Why you can't, I mean, you can't, at some stage in the game, you just wait a minute. Okay, now what's the odds of this? You can't find no images or no black men that have not been broken or one way or another, and they hold up with our movements, our music, our movies. You know what I'm saying? You listen to the lyrics of Jay-Z. Listen to the disdain he has for his biological father. Look at the state you live in, and look at how they bring in live corn as a surrogate father. You know what I'm saying? This is the consistency. This is you'll be hard pressed. Look at, you know what I'm saying, how the individuals that they raise up and place them up, you know what I'm saying, as spokesperson for our struggle, for our music, for our movement, you name it.
Yeah, that's true though. I definitely said, and I remember like a while back we were speaking about the COINTELPRO situation. I mean, I kind of know about it from my own understanding, but then hearing, like, how we were bending on the fear of a black messiah and some of these points they were using to take out people away. And it's just like what you ties in to what you were saying, like the manipulation, like they want us to think that we ain't in a position. Like, even with the statistic, like, they'll tell us that there are more black young men in jail than there is in college, but we see the truth, like the statistics in fact show that there are more young black men in college than they are locked up by hundreds of thousands of statistics, like hundreds of thousands of numbers.
Even with the numbers of the colleges, though. Even the numbers of the colleges. How does that look at the individuals that they produce? You know what I'm saying? It's still at the expense of disconnecting from our people. You know what I'm saying? Why is it with our people? These slave success stories, Why does their education, or better yet, their training, come at the expense of disconnect from our people? Why do you have a U.S. president, Robert F. Kennedy, who was up front proud about his Irish descent? You know what I'm saying? Why is it those that they train with? It comes at the expense of a disconnect from us. you know what I'm saying? Minister E.P. Newton said we must take the bourgeoisie skills and make them work in the interest of the masses. It's vice versa with us. At the expense of making it, you must disconnect. You have go look at the contracts with Shaquille O'Neal and the rest of these slaves. They showed their contract with them. They said, if you have a family member that has a felony, you can't associate with them. You know what I'm saying? This is the type of, at the expense of a disconnect from anything with us, you know what I'm saying? And then they bring them back to be around us and to be black when it's beneficial. You know what I'm saying? Other communities, it's a connect to their community. You know what I'm saying? So I'm not, you know what I'm saying, all people, Bill Cosby donated this money for this. I'm not for help bring some more slaves. You know what I'm saying? Promote some more individuals, you know what I'm saying, who going to make it at the expense of, you know what I'm saying, at the expense of disconnecting from our people. How does that benefit, you know what I'm saying? I mean, benefit the community, you know what I'm saying? The people, you follow what I'm saying? It holds people, it sends a message, you know what I'm saying? It's the only way that you can make, you know what I'm saying, at the expense of cutting away. But you look at the other communities, those resources are generated back into their respective communities. You know, they don't say, hey, but Justin Timberlake, it reflects their community, you know what I'm saying? As opposed to our people, they, you know what I'm saying, they are trained. It's like in the movie The Butler. They moved the butler. The butler, he knew everything about French wine and different where the cigars came from. He didn't know about no protests going down right down the street. He had no concept of it. Well, black folks were going through right down the street. He knew all these different languages, all what was going on. You know what I'm saying? So it's worse than a dog. You know what I'm saying? Like a dog can't defend itself. Like you go to some of them places. Me and Face was talking one time. Me and Face, I was telling Face, get a boy, say, man, Face. Then it's certain arenas that they won't even let you in. I said, man, we like them dogs on the Houston dog channel where they do some dogs. They come save them dogs. Some of these people they go and say, you know what? We can save him. We can bring him back. We can take that to our daughter. She's looking for a pet. I said, Face, we the type of guys they come in as soon as they see us and say, down them. Down them. You know what I'm saying? Down them. And if some dogs, they can go and you look at, you walk in, you see vicious pit bull fights. They walk in and the pit bulls are fighting and cutting and getting down with each other. But with the white dog catcher can walk in without unmolested, no problem. You know what I'm saying? These people that you told me that they're trained, you know what I'm saying? They what was his name? Ben Carson. You know what I'm saying? This dude ain't got ain't benefited. That's why you think Trump. You know what I'm saying? Trump is really doing what all of them been doing. Trump, let you know, this type of Negro that can be raised up. You know what I'm saying? As long as it does not go back to the respective community. You know what I'm saying? Adolf, the Olympics. Adolf Hitler said he wouldn't allow nobody from the Jewish community to be up there. The U.S. said, listen, this is how we do this. We do the same thing in America. We grab a certain type of Negro. You know what I'm saying? He said, this is what we do. He's giving them heads up. Man, listen, don't worry about this. We do this with Ralph Metcalf, Jesse Owens, the rest of these people, Jackie Robinson, all of them. They're not connected to no black folks. So Adolf Hitler said, okay, cool. He wouldn't get somebody who was technically can be referred to as from the Jewish community. But you know what I'm saying? The whole, the features, everything, the blonde hair, the blue eyes, all of that. You know what I'm saying? He gave no inspiration, no connect. No tangible contribution back to our people. So I'm saying all them different things with Kaepernick, Jay-Z, the rest of these, all them donations, ain't nothing going back to our people. And they know it. It presents no threat. None. Now what they will do, they're going to some little softball tax write-off type of event, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? It's really, really technically, if you want, legally speaking, it's a money laundering scheme. Then you know what I'm saying? Donate this money to the same institution, same system, where the money come right back to the same ones got our foot on our backs. I defy you. Name me one on the ground organization. Name me one authentic. I ain't talking about no GMOs, no government made organizations. Name me one organization. Kaepernick, Jay-Z, any one of them, they donate some resources to. I'll wait.
None of them. Even Black Lives Matter, they done went a whole different direction.
They ain't went no different direction. Sellout is one of the most overused terms in the black community. The word sellout is one of the most overused terms in our community. Oh, I can't believe this, man. OJ Simpson sold out. What? Man, you go talk to his grammar school buddies. inch, man. What? I can't believe this. See, we have, a lot of times we have a reactionary assessment of history. People tell me they can't believe Donald Trump said he said about Africa. This is how America been getting down to Africa all through. This is from Africa all the time. They made Donald Trump. They said you shouldn't say that. They didn't say he shouldn't do that. You shouldn't say it that way. He's articulating what's been the policies all during the strip. The organizations that they give you. You know what I'm saying? It's nothing personal, it's political. They don't say, you watch who they raise up for you, who they give to you. You know what I'm saying? If you were in the streets, if you're a Crip, you see the Bloods keep on saying, we love this Crip. This is the best Crip we ever seen in our life. You say, wait a minute, man. Who is this guy they keep holding up? When you see the organizations, the individuals they keep on raising up and giving you all the time, you say, whoa, wait a minute, man. There's something up with this here. So these people have not went wayward. It is what it is. And I don't, you know what I'm saying? And it's pros and cons. And, you know, ain't it all good and all bad. Some of these entities can be served possibly as a gateway drug for some people, because they can't handle the Black Panther Party clubs in the raw. They need to go through some, you know what I'm saying, whatever, you know? However, the deal is, you need contradictions. Contradictions exist, you know what I'm saying? Minister UEP News say contradictions are the ruling principle of the universe. You know what I'm saying? So they're necessary. You know what I'm saying? However, you know what I'm saying? And one thing, according to Chicago, it was a structure. It was a, you know what I'm saying? Check it. You gotta be careful playing political gumbo. You know what I'm saying? Mixing everything together. No, this is this. This is that.
Absolutely. So, beloved brother, we coming to the last little 5 minutes on the show. Like you had in the closing, you want to let the people know how to find you. Also, let the people know about the Mile Radio show.
Yeah, y'all tune in to check it out this Wednesday, every Wednesday. Free Mile Radio. Chairman Fred Hampton Jr. and also Robin Allen, a.k.a. the Lady of Rage. Every Wednesday, 6:30 p.m., they can Google it. Free Mile Radio. Then tune in with us. Call in number 929-477-3785. Press 1. We need people's support. Save the hashtag, save the Hampton House. We fighting for the house with Chairman Fred Hampton grew up in, Maywood, Illinois. We need support. We need, you know what I'm saying, August 30th, the Chairman Fred Street Party. Everybody come on to Chicago. You know what I'm saying? We need everybody up here. We need all Pauls up. We need all Pauls on deck. Fighting for that. I need to find on Facebook at Fred Hampton. Email Chairman Fred Jr. at gmail.com. You know what I'm saying? Phone contact 773-256-9451. Man, email Black Panther Party Cubs 124@gmail.com. I appreciate you, brother, for this interview. Appreciate your time. I appreciate, you know what I'm saying, man, I'll be all there talking to you, yo, brother. Man, the last minute calls, we didn't have to call you to help with their propaganda, getting the flyers together, man. We appreciate you, brother. Real talk.
Yeah, you know I'll be on the clutches.
We call you at 11:55 on the Thursday, baby, brother. You finish at 12 noon, December 4th. You say what, next year? No, tomorrow, today.
Yeah, I'll be killing me, man. I'm talking about y'all. I got the content coming for you soon. Like the event started at 2 p.m. Like, man, I got the content coming to you.
They at the door. The people are right there calling on the way and say, I need to put on my Facebook. I need to post this right now. Yes, sir. Appreciate
yes, indeed. Yeah, speaking of that, try to get me the content for that new flight that you want me to do.
I'm on that right now. I'm going to call ASAP. And text me. Okay, how can people find this archive show? And could you tag my Facebook page with this show, this archive show?
Yeah, I think I tagged you, Chairman Fred Hampton, right?
I'm on Fred Hampton now. I don't have a Chairman Fred Hampton page. I'm on Fred Hampton on Facebook.
Yeah, I'm about to post on your timeline now. Hey, man, y'all been on real. Y'all, thank y'all for tuning in, man. Peace and love. I'm tagging you now, bro.
Peace and love. Primo. Thank you, bro.
Forever. All right.
Peace and love, Primo.
Oh, Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. Forgive us of our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Thy is the kingdom, the power, the glory. Amen.